Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, furs of all species. I'm Dayzee Hyena, and welcome to our first ever Q&A. Now, I like to be pretty interactive with all my viewers. That's why whenever y'all comment or something, I usually like to respond, because, you know, it's fun. So, I thought, hey, what's better to show my appreciation than to answer some of y'all's questions about me and my channel and whatever that. So, I went on all my Instagram, Twitter, and Furry Amino, and I asked what questions y'all have for me. So we're gonna see what y'all asked. Okay, for my Furry Amino. Fritz Ju from Furry Amino asked, do you do art trades? Unfortunately, I can't do art trades right now. I don't really even have time to do art for myself anymore because, you know, I want to keep up with the channel as much as possible and have consistent videos every single time, you know, and I can't really promise any art based off of that. I barely get time to, you know, draw anymore. So, unfortunately, no. Okay? Phonix asked, how did you create your persona or OC? What inspired you? Well, I actually have a story time on how I got Dayzee. Now, the only real thing I chose was to be a hyena, but the design and everything was pretty much all pre-made by my sister, who's a fursuit maker. So I kind of just walked in one day with her making a pre-made and go, I want that! So that's how I ended up getting Dayzee. Toy. What is the airspeed velocity of an unladen swallow?
What? Is the airspeed velocity of an unladen swallow?
What do you mean? An African or European swallow?
Huh? I don't know that.
Who do you know so much about swallows?
Well, you have to know these things when you're a king, you know.
Riker Foxwolf, what pushed you to become the YouTuber you are today? Well, it's kind of weird. It just literally one day I woke up and went, huh, I want to be a YouTuber. So that's what I put my mind to it. And y'all probably don't know this, but I have the worst luck. Like, my luck is garbage. And so actually, like, getting to this point where I'm posting videos took over 2 years. And so much money went up down the drain because I had no idea what I was doing. And every time I would finally find something and it would work for a nanosecond, something would happen and it would just all go down the drain. And I'm just, it just got to me. But honestly, as far as like my goals and stuff for the channel, you know, I just want to have fun. I don't do videos so people will like me. I make videos for people who are like me. Junior asks, what do you mean when you say furs of all species in the beginning of your videos? Well, that means, like, you know, there's hyena furries, there's wolf furries, there's bird furries, there's lizards and gators and hippos and elephants and squirrels and foxes and cats and dogs. So, furs of all species. I want everyone to feel like included here. So, if you're any species, furs of all species, you're welcome here. Now, for my Instagram, Nick Furry asked, what made you a furry? My sister. She was like the fur first, and, you know, she's good at the mind games and converting people into furries. Like, she'll have that subliminal messaging shit with her mind. And she would show me, like, vines of furs dancing and stuff, and, you know, that made me go, huh, that looks fun, I wanna try it. And, of course, I can't dance, so I just watched other people dancing, and I thought it was, like, really cool, so I decided, hey, I want to be one of those. So, that's how I joined. Cry the Wusky says, what's your favorite thing about the fandom? Well, my favorite thing with all the friends I make here, because, you know, it always feels like every single fur I meet, you know, automatically, like, hey, we're friends, we're cool. Like, for me, with other furs, you are super nice until proven dick. Like, you're super awesome until you prove to me you're an asshole. Yeah, I really like all the people in the furry fandom. You know, there are some groups that are, let's say, unsavory. And, you know, I don't mess with those. But for the most part, everyone's really nice. Okay. Katsy Caponi asked, why did you pick a hyena? Because I have a stupid laugh. I remember I was at a FurCon with my sister and we were at this open mic night and I was laughing, so my ugly stupid laugh, and then I looked at my sister and I was just like, hey, I should be a hyena, so then if I laugh all this gross way, they'll just look at me and go, oh, part of her character. Like, literally, if you see any of my vids and stuff, I'll be laughing at myself and it'll sound weird. I have the weirdest laugh ever. So, that's why I chose a hyena. And then on Twitter, Mixed Fluff Studio asks, Maws or Paws? Oh, woo.
Both. Both is good.
So that's all the questions that were asked on my socials. Make sure you follow me so you can get all the info and updates, and every once in a while I'll post something stupid on there, so make sure you check that out. If you like what you see, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe so you can see my content in the future. Also, while you're here, check out my Danganronpa gameplays and my story times. I'm Dayzee Hyena, and I'll catch you on the next vid.